What is the state of AI? Where have we gotten? And what does the road ahead look like? What are some of the things that people should be watching out? And I'm not going to ask the usual dumb question of 5 years, because who the hell knows? Yeah. But, like, you know, 6 to 12 months, that's good.
Yeah, I do think it's impossible to know what things will look like in 5 years. But, I mean, there's certainly a lot going on. And I think the thing that we've seen over the past couple of years since GPT-4 and ChatGPT burst onto the public scene is we have a huge amount of activity with people trying to figure out what these technological breakthroughs mean for them. Like, you know, what are the possibilities? What are the concerns that are coming with these tools? You know, I think it's really inspiring to see all of the creative and entrepreneurial energy that people who have leaned into the possibility, who are taking an optimistic point of view, like just even the early things that they're creating. And like the thing that I will say is I do believe that we're in very early innings of like this AI platform shift. So the thing that I've been reminding folks of lately is the structure of the ecosystem is that the frontier advances almost in bursts. And so, you know, like we have a breakthrough like GPT-3 or GPT-4, and then we wait a little while before the next thing comes. And like the reason for that is like it just takes a while to go build all of the technical infrastructure to like increase the compute and solve a whole bunch of scientific problems that result in the next breakthrough. And like the past handful of years, the breakthroughs have come almost every other year. So, and the thing to remember is GPT-4 was about 2 years ago. And so the thing I think everyone should be looking forward to this year is like the next update will happen. And it will almost certainly be what we've seen in the past updates. So a whole bunch of things where the AI infrastructure is brittle and too expensive and barely capable of solving a handful of problems, all of a sudden those things will get cheap and easy, and you know, things will perform better. And then we will get a handful of like interesting new emergent things. So like things that have made the phase transition from impossible to possible. And like those are the hardest things to predict, but they're also the ones that are, you know, the most surprising and often lead to the biggest opportunities. And so for builders, like the best frame of mind to be in is like just awareness that more improvements are coming, like the next big update is coming, and like what can I do to be in a good position to avail myself of those opportunities as soon as the update happens. And for folks who are thinking about, you know, what does this mean on a philosophical level? Like, how do we deal with risk? How do we, you know, sort of understand what all the impacts of the technology are going to be, positive and negative? Like, you also have to be aware that the next thing is coming, and to, you know, not frame either your optimism or your pessimism in terms of, you know, the incremental extensions to like the last update that happened.